Hello and welcome back to Wireless Communication Lecture Series. In this video lecture, you are going to learn about channel assignment strategies and difference between co-channel and adjacent channel interference. So let's start with channel assignment strategy. So basically, this is the method for utilizing radio resources in a proper manner. Now let me tell you, when operators are purchasing the frequency or frequency band, so operator means Airtel, Vodafone, Idea or whatever operator in your country or region. So they are purchasing the frequency band, and this frequency band is very limited and it is a scarce. So we have to utilize this radio resources very carefully. And therefore, we required such a method like channel assignment strategy or frequency reuse. There are lots of concepts in cellular system that will help us to utilize radio resources very properly. So basically, it is for efficient utilization of radio spectrum. And we have also discussed about frequency reuse scheme that is consists with objective of increasing capacity and minimizing the interference in the system. So if we talk about channel assignment strategies, they are basically of two types, fixed and dynamic. So now let's discuss about difference between fixed channel assignment strategy and dynamic channel assignment strategy. So in a fixed channel assignment strategy, each cell is allocated a predetermined set of voice channels. So whatever frequency that you have got, you are dividing that frequency and you are assigning a fixed number of channel to particular cell. So here the, let's say we are saying that we are assigning a 10 number of channel to particular cell. So they are limited by 10 only. Now in dynamic, each time a call request is made, the serving base station requests a channel from the MSC. So here we are not assigning a fixed number of channel, and we are utilizing the all the channels in all the cells, and that will be controlled by the MSC. So if we will talk about in fixed channel assignment strategy, so you can see that any call attempt within the cell can only be served by the unused channel in that particular cell. So if let's say we have 10 number of channel and the capacity of this cell is limited by this 10 number of channel only. So if there is more user, then the call will be obviously going to be blocked. Whereas in the dynamic channel assignment strategy, the switch allocates a channel to request cell following an algorithm that take into account the likelihood of future blocking within the cell, the frequency of use of candidate channel and the reuse distance of the channel and other cost function. So in a dynamic channel assignment strategy, whenever MSC is assigning a channel, it is taking care of the frequency that we are allocating, and it is also taking care of the reuse distance, and based upon that only the MSC will allocate a channel. In a fixed channel, if all the channels in the cell are occupied, the call is blocked. Let's say we have a 10 channel, and if we have utilized all this 10 channel, our call is going to be blocked and the subscriber does not receive service. So this is the disadvantage of fixed channel assignment strategy. Now in a dynamic channel assignment reduces the likelihood of blocking, which increases the trunking capacity of the system, and since all the available channel in a market are accessible to all the cell. So dynamic is advantageous in this way that we can assign any number of channel to the cells, and let's say in one cell we have a more number of users, so we can assign a more number of channel to that particular cell. So this is the advantage of dynamic channel assignment strategy. Now to overcome the blocking issue in the fixed channel assignment strategy, we can use a borrowing strategy. In a borrowing strategy, a cell is allowed to borrow channel from neighboring cell if all of its own channel are already occupied. and this channel will be allocated with consideration of avoiding co-channel interference. And if you will talk about dynamic, the MSC only allocate a given frequency if that frequency is not presently in use in the cell or any other cell. So basically in both the thing we have to avoid the co-channel interference. So if you will compare, the computational load on the system is less in the fixed channel assignment strategy, whereas here MSC have to do a lots of work, and therefore it will increase the storage and computational load on the system as well as on the MSC. So these are the difference between the fixed channel and dynamic channel assignment strategy. So next we are going to discuss about co-channel interference and adjacent channel interference. So before that, let me tell you what is co-cell and adjacent cell. So co-cell means the cell that have same set of frequency. So let's say here we have a 1 and again we have a 1. So we are saying that these two cell have a same set of frequency and they are a co-cell. Similarly, adjacent cell means the cell that have adjacent frequency. That means let's consider that one cell have a 900 megahertz of frequency, and this adjacent frequency, let's say 901, or it can be a 899 megahertz. So these all are the adjacent frequency, and any interference between this adjacent frequency is known as the adjacent channel interference. So let's see first point. The interference between signals from co-cell is called as a co-channel interference. And in case of adjacent channel interference, this interference is resulting from signals which are adjacent in frequency to the desired signal is called the adjacent channel interference. Second, we have an increase in carrier transmit power, increase in the interference to neighboring co-channel cell. So in a co-channel cell, if you will increase the power, so reuse distance between these two cell will of course going to be reduced, and that will result in a more interference. So we have to carefully decide our carrier transmit power in order to control the co-channel interference. Whereas in adjacent channel interference, it results from the imperfect receiver filters which allow nearby frequency to leak into the passband. So if you know about receiver, so in the receiver you have initial filter that will filter out the frequency and that will pass only particular band. Now if your filter is not strong and it is allowing a nearby frequency, so that can also cause the adjacent channel interference. Third difference, to reduce the co-channel interference, the co-channel cells must be physically separated by a minimum distance to provide sufficient isolation due to propagation. So the first option that we can do is we can make this distance as large as possible. And in case of adjacent channel, the near-far effect occurs when mobile close to one base station transmit on channel close to one being used by a weak mobile. So sometimes it happens that the user which is near to the base station will transmit at very high power, and the user which is away from the base station will receive a very less power. So this is near far effect, and this near far effect is occurring in a cellular system, and that can also cause adjacent channel interference. If you will talk about another solution of co-channel interference, then we can use cell sectoring, microcell zone concept. I have already explained these two topics. You can watch my previous video lecture and you can learn about what is cell sectoring and microcell zone concept and how they are reducing the co-channel interference. Now we can minimize the adjacent channel interference by proper filtering and by assigning a proper channel to the particular cell. So this is all about difference between co-channel and adjacent channel interference. I hope this information are very useful to you. Give your feedback in the comment and don't forget to subscribe this channel. Thank you so much for watching the video.